Alright, let's get going. So the first program I'm going to use is Renoise. Now Renoise is not just a sampler. Renoise is basically a DAW, but what I am using it for here is the sampler. The cool thing about Renoise is that they also have a VST plugin called Redux, so you can use the sounds you create in there also in other DAWs like Ableton Live. I like to work in the full version though, so I will drag in this sample. Let's see, I actually want to use, why do I have this if I'm not using it? Now I want to find a good part. I think it's around here. I will copy this part into a new instrument and then maximize the volume. I can still hear myself. That's horrible. Let's delete this. We don't need the whole thing. Let's delete this part too. Now I'm going to make a loop. Now let's see how this loop works. Nice. What I like about this is that it already has a pitch. So let's copy this. No, duplicate. Now how Renoise works, you have here the modulation section basically. You can modulate volume, panning, pitch, and then here's something you can choose freely, like a filter or amplitude modulation, and you have different modulation sources that you can use, and you can have as many of those modulation sets as you want. So you can have one for every sample, or you can send all samples to the same one. I will now try to find a single cycle. Let's look at this waveform. I will put the filter on this. Check this pitch. That's that. Let's delete this. And then we can bring this back in. So I want to duplicate this again, and then let's put this through another set, and I will change the waveform. Let's see, I will put this. And here. I would like to let those two I like the sound, but I'm somehow missing what we had in the beginning, like the sound of the ocean, basically. Another piece and see what we can do. Copy. Insert. Let's put this down here and then paste. Maximize the volume. I will put on a fixed chain only for this. It actually sounds nice when it's very low. That's cool. Let's recap. I took two different parts from this recording and then added modulations to that. For the first sample, it's basically only a volume envelope. Second set, volume envelope and LFO for panning. And then I have a low pass filter. The third set also has a volume envelope and LFO for panning. That goes in the opposite direction. That's important. So the two LFOs have the same speed and the same amplitude, but they're out of phase, 180 degrees. That's why when one note is on the left, the other is on the right. So they're going back and forth. So that's what's happening here. And the fourth set is again only a volume envelope. I think it works best as a drone, like this. Let me know what you think. Thank you for watching and let's get to the next one.